In that first half, showed the ability to throw the football.
It's Raynaud at the goal line. Gets a small crease and bounces across the 25. Darren Andrews. Game and keep throwing it. So there's nothing wrong with the left arm. And Slayton bounces it. Gets the corner, gets 10 yards. Again, only the second positive run he's had. Revis, who had the touchdown of the punt
end zone to really spark this Pitt team.
White, toe looks okay. Gets around the corner, has a crease. Pat White. Gone.
Pat White on the West Virginia touchdown.
Limping out of the field. And then sprinting in the end zone, 64 yards. Imagine if he were 100%, Kirk, I tell you.
Yeah. How about the triple option? Read right there. The guy, the defensive end comes down. That tells the quarterback to pull the ball. And this is just magic. This is just creativity and athletic ability in the open field. But with two backs in the backfield that time, this is another one of the adjustments that you have to deal with in the variety of the offense. Owen Schmidt up the middle. You're reading the defensive end. The end collapsed. He pulled the ball, and then he takes it to the next level, and nobody could stop him getting to the end zone.
So White, no ill effects of that turf toe, takes it to the house. Yet another lead change, and it's the Mountaineers back on top in backyard brawl number 99.
That's more of his wheelhouse,
sure.
More of his comfort zone there, running the football.
Short kickoff taken by T.J. Porter, who stumbles ahead to the 30. Another look.
Well, the look here, we talked about the defensive end, Joe Klerman. That's going to be the read for Pat White. And you're going to have Owen Schmidt coming right there. Watch out Pat White's eyes. He's just going to go right there. Once the end commits down, quarterback's going to come right here. Typically, there's somebody right here to force him to pitch. But this is an X factor. This is speed. And Raynaud gets in the way of Campbell just enough to allow him to get to the outside and use him as a shield. And then down the sideline, he goes for a touchdown.
First down throw by Palko. Dumps it over the middle. Right into traffic. Stevens howling, gains about five. Coaches getting up over there. That's a spirited discussion. Is that Tony Gibson, the defensive backs coach, getting in the face of some of his guys?
Yeah, it's ironic in the week of Bobby Knight just barely giving a little bit of a, what would you call that?
Kind of popped him under the chin.
Popped him under the chin to get his attention. It's ironic to see this right here. And that's, as a player, that's kind of part of the game there, especially in this one.
And football's kind of expected. Hoops, yeah. Not so much. Malco, pressured. He'll throw it away. Was looking initially for Cibukas, the tight end in the slot, but Reed Williams jumped in there.
Looks like the Home Depot coaching adjustment, at least for a couple plays. We've seen West Virginia's defense play with some enthusiasm up front, getting after Tyler Palko, at least getting into a third and five.
Tyler's got to calm down now. He's getting in his receiver's face.
I think he feels that he's seeing a blitz here. They're showing it. Let's see if they tricked him or if they actually come with the blitz here. Now they're sitting back.
They leave the tight end in to protect, and he fires into traffic, almost intercepted by Antonio Lewis. Well, Derek Turner was there, but Lewis had his hands on it. And the Mountaineers get a three and out stop.
The Mountaineers showing early, before he actually made his check, that they were going to come. I think he forced, looked to his right, thinking the blitz was coming over the slot. By the time he got his eyes back to the left to his intended receiver, Turner, Lewis almost stepped in front of it and returned it for a touchdown. Nice job of disguising the blitz and then sitting back into the zone by the Mountaineers.
Pittsburgh forced to punt for the first time tonight. Adam Gressel. Mountaineers pointing to the Panthers.
Prior to the snap, false start, number 44 on the offense, 5-yard penalty, remains fourth down.
The ironic part about that last play is Matt Kavanaugh told us that Tyler, I asked him, any check with me at the line, any freedom? Do you give any freedom to Tyler Palco? He said, it's ironic you bring that up. There's Coach Kavanaugh, the offense coordinator, talking with Palco. He said, we've got a three wide receiver set where we're going to give him the check with me at the line. And that time we just saw that and it backfired on Palco.
Well played game, Kirk. Only two penalties, a 5-yarder for each team now. Bressel, good looking boot. Ron Rivers in traffic, hit immediately. Jameel Brady, the defensive back, nice job covering. 42-yard punt, and no return. Kirk, he'll be joined by Bob Davey and Brent Musburger in the booth Saturday afternoon. West Virginia up by 4, back in business, and they hand it off to Slayton.
Staying focused here tonight. Got to throw in a promo here about Saturday.
Does that throw you off?
No,
you haven't
good.
Slept
I'm
all
good.
Week, and
yeah,
you wound up.
I'm excited. I'm flat out giddy. Cannot wait for Saturday afternoon.
Have a second down and 6.
See those two.
I get it.
Powerhouses collide, in Columbus.
I'm going to have to maintain you and Desmond on opposite ends of the set. Corso in his own orbit in the middle. I got my hands full Saturday. They flip it out there to Slayton. Looks for the crease. His patient dives across the 40 and has a first down. There you see the other side of Slayton, the runner. Not just pure acceleration and speed, but the patience reading his blocks.
Well, it's a lot about having patience as a runner, but it's also one of the things that Rich Rodriguez demands from receivers. Top of the screen. Look at the wide receivers. Not great blocks, not dominant blocks. What they call that is stalk blocking. And you're basically just trying to keep yourself between the defensive back and the ball carrier. They did enough there to allow him to get a seam to the first.
You don't have to do much to create a seam. And there's a seam, and there's Slayton. Forget about it. A flag comes in late as Slayton reaches the end zone. 59 yards, but we'll check the marker back at the Pittsburgh 40. The marker came flying out way after Slayton had left that area.
It was right in the holding area.
Sure was. But the flag came out after Slayton was long gone. The infraction may have been earlier.
It takes time to reach
holding,
for it.
Holding, number 7.
Brandon Miles.
You can't call it on the play by All-American Center. You give the DB the flag in that one.
Right.
High snap and White. Shoots ahead, breaks free of a tackle momentarily. First down at the 43 of Pittsburgh. So the first major penalty of the night nullifies what would have been another touchdown for Slayton.
This Pitt defense struggling tonight to stop Pat White and Steve Slayton. Something to remember is they played pretty well with the exception of last week against UConn when they were up 31-17 with 8 minutes to go. And gave up 317 rushing yards to UConn. You got to wonder if a little bit of that hangover is affecting their confidence tonight.
White corralled for a loss. Gus Mustakas. Floridian there on the stop. Gave up 45 points to West Virginia a year ago. Dave Wansett's comment on halftime. We just got to run faster. Got to get faster as a defense. Well, not a lot faster this year. It's been another big night so far for the West Virginia offense. They're on a 500-yard pace plus.
You get the feeling that the only way Pitt can stop West Virginia is if either West Virginia stops themselves or they create a turnover.
It's Nate Sowers now in the slot to the near side, the backup quarterback. But Slayton takes the handoff and slams into traffic up the middle for a 1-yard gain. Mackenzie Matthews, the young true freshman defensive end. He's been relieved of his starting duties tonight, but getting some reps in here.
That was a great play by the defensive end, Joe Clarman, who just stuck Jake Fittner and drove him back in behind the line of scrimmage, and Steve Slayton ran right into the back of his own offensive tackle. Clarman showing some serious strength there.
Slayton motions to the slot on 3rd and 11. White is tracked down near the marker. He did not get the first down. Mustakas chased him down. Not bad for 265-pounder.
Chris, he's pretty athletic right here. He's not even going to try to get to Pat White. He has Dan Moses, and he's almost playing like a linebacker. He's spying him, and that's asking a lot for a big 265-pound defensive tackle.
They'll go for it on fourth and a long yard. 3 for 5 on fourth down this year. It's White going to throw it downfield.
Since those interceptions, 3.
They don't challenge him.
Nope. That's why.
Good job by Reed Williams. He grabbed the ankle of Stevens Howling. 1 yard loss.
It'd be great to go into some illustration and a great lecture on the difference in the second half and what these defenses are doing. What we've seen, I know Pat White's gotten out a couple times, what we're seeing is when they're effective, it comes down to the defensive line. The defensive line getting penetration and winning the battle. I think they're doing a lot of the same thing schematically.
Pittsburgh may just shelve the running game. Malco, he'll be sacked for the first time. Bublikle got him. The guy who missed a tackle here 2 years ago and allowed Palco to get in the end zone for the winning touchdown did not miss that one.
He went right through the tailback. Stevens Howling, 175 pounds. Boom, he actually holds on for the ride all the way back to Palco. Bublikle is the leader of this defense as a senior. He understands this rivalry as well as anybody, and that time got the pressure on Palco.
He understands that he's got 80 pounds on Stevens Howling.
He went right through it.
255 versus 175. And now it's the West Virginia defense with a big series here. Third and long for Palco, who's pressured again. Tyler able to elude tacklers for a while, still alive. Dumps it short, caught by the fullback across the 35. Not a first down. A flag is down. Antonio Lewis on the stop.
This is usually a clip or a man downfield, one or the other, because that's Tyler Palco from 2 years ago. That's what Matt Kavanaugh's worked so hard on getting out of his game. This is designed to roll to the right, but the pressure just came from Ivy on the backside. He's actually able to shake off Reed Williams, and now he's just searching, trying to make something big happen on third down. He's lucky enough to complete the pass. That's what Matt Kavanaugh spoke so yesterday. That's all he talked about, is how he's been avoiding those kind of plays.
They declined the penalty because it was short of the first down. And here's Gressel. Vaughn Rivers back deep. Lets it bounce, and it'll be down inside the 5. Introducing you to the academic side of college life.
Okay.
Not that I spend a lot of time in the library.
He's
Boulder. Mountaineers pinned back after the nice punt. But Slayton looking to improve the field position in a hurry. Look out, Steve Slayton is collared over there. A flag flies. He'll tack on 15 to the run as Revis got him by the face mask. That's a nice way to improve that field position.
Well, it is. And what happened there is Tommy Campbell took himself out of position by getting so excited that they had the West Virginia offense
personal
pinned.
Foul, face mask, number 25 on the defense, 15-yard penalty from the end of the play. First down.
Watch to the left of your screen. Tommy Campbell coming way inside, making it for an easy block for Renaud. And then it's just speed to the corner. And very fortunate that I know Revis came up with a nasty face mask.
But ripped the whole hat off.
Yeah, he's lucky that Slayton didn't go right by him. That's how you get out of the being pinned inside your 5-yard line. You find number 10 in white.
Yeah, about 8 seconds later, you're in Pittsburgh territory. Panther defense again needs to rise up here. Mountaineers looking to build in a 4-point lead. White keeps it. White has a crease. White rolls down near the 20. How about that? Two plays sandwiched around a penalty. They go from their own 2 The other guy's 20.
It's the exact same play we saw earlier, only this time towards McKenzie Matthews, the freshman. He's going to read it again. Slayton comes down, and this is a little bit different, and Clint Session in space gets exposed. The reason it's different is this time he reads it by riding Slayton and being willing to pitch the ball to the outside to Schmidt. That's why you can't really get a feel or any tendencies on West Virginia. They'll go either way.
Slayton running left to stop. We have ex-Panther great Bill Frelick, who's number 79, is one of the many guys who I'm sure has memories of backyard brawls in the past. White still got it. He's got a crease, and he's got a touchdown. What do you think, Bill? Is that great offensive line blocking or just fast backs?
Well, I'll tell you what, those two guys would make me come back out of retirement. You know, Slayton and White just put so much pressure on you and as a defense. And, you know, we've got a young one, defensive line, trying their
hardest. Look at that hole.
Yeah, I mean, you know, Clint Session's out there in space, not sure if he's going to pitch it or not. And it just put so much pressure on. And you've seen tonight that White can throw the football, too, pretty well when forced to.
I sure can. It was all about the forward pass in the first half, 201 yards. But now they get back to the A game, Kirk, the running game in the second half. And now they lead by 10, 11 with the PAT.
Back. Graham off the floor. I think Dave Wannstedt's going to take it to another level. It's going to take a few years. I like the way he coaches football. I like his mentality. I think it's what you see in successful teams of any level. And it's going to take a little bit of time, but I think at the end, if we're patient enough, we're going to see an excellent football team out of Dave Wannstedt.
This Doran Dickerson has been the scout team quarterback for Wannstedt, simulating Pat White in practice with a kickoff return. And now some urgency for Wannstedt's offense, down by 11 inside of 5 minutes to play in the third quarter. If they can't get the win here, though, Bill, lose a fourth in a row, you get Louisville next week. I mean, will people in Pittsburgh be happy with a 6-6? I mean, it's not a lot of evidence of this thing going in the right direction. No. If they can't turn it around here.
Yeah, when you lose five games in a row, it puts pressure on you, and, you know, you'd be naive to think otherwise. But, you know, there's still time here, and I, you know, that to me, when he came here, I knew the one thing that could keep him from getting to where he needed to get to was not.
There's this three wide receiver formation where he has some flexibility and the ability to call the play at the line of scrimmage.
Fakes the pitch and hands it off to Stevens Howling, and there's a flag in the holding zone. It will be holding against the Panthers. Been a real problem for this Pittsburgh offensive line. They
holding,
had five.
Number 68 on the offense. 10-yard penalty from the line of scrimmage. Repeat first down.
Five holding penalties against USF, which just killed their efforts in that game. That's Joe Villani, the center. Hadn't been a real penalized team all season. One of the better teams in this conference in that department. But at key moments, some of these losses, penalties have popped up.
Well, especially when you get down 11 in a hurry and you haven't been able to be as productive as you were in the first half. And you get a little bit of momentum going, and then they have to start it back at first and 20.
Falco fires far side, making the catch on his knees over there is Kinder. They get back 11.
But Bill Frelick just made a good point, and the fact that there's still plenty of time. I think it's still going to come down to whether or not Pitt can stop Steve Slayton and Pat White, because
sure.
I think Tyler Palko will continue to put pressure on the Mountaineer defense. It's a matter of time till he makes a big play and gets them into the end zone.
On the stretch, Stevens Howling will be dropped for a loss. The running game just hasn't been there at all. Matt Kavanaugh hoping for enough of a running game they wouldn't have to throw the ball 40 times, but it hasn't developed.
And I understand what he's trying to do. He is seeking balance. He wants to make the defense be aware of both the run and the throw, because that's what his offense is built around. But, Chris, only 26 yards rushing. They're going to live and die now with Tyler Palko's arm.
Yeah, less than 2 yards a carry running the ball. Third and 10. You may have two plays to get these 10 yards. Off the corner comes Lewis on the blitz, and he's got Palko for a huge loss. Antonio Lewis, Kirky, has been a little bit in the doghouse, lost his starting job, but a big play there.
Well, this is the advantage of disguising the blitz and pulling back and then showing the blitz and coming. Tyler Palko's eyes go to the right. By the time he comes back to the play side, Lewis is in his face and there's nothing that he can do. And the way he reacted, there was some confusion up front with the offensive line about the pass protection and how to take care of the quarterback.
So much for trying to go for it on fourth down after the 15-yard loss. There's this short punt, which can be covered at about the 32. Lewis makes a play, and now West Virginia will try to build.
Huge game.
Raynaud can't slip the tackle. Tommy Campbell, the linebacker there. Linebacker fast enough to be trusted to cover a wide receiver one-on-one. But you better make that tackle.
Can't Pitt get a turnover?
Boy.
I mean, that's what it's going to come down to. Can they get a turnover? Because I don't think they're going to stop this Pat White offense right now.
And 25 takeaways on the season. They're pretty good in that category, but none tonight. White fires downfield. Incomplete. He overthrew Bolden.
Well, the last drive was more about what West Virginia has built their reputation on, pinned inside their own 5-yard line. Steve Slayton bounces it, gets some blocks, and then just uses his speed, tack on 15 more. And then it's the read, the triple option. This time with Steve Slayton up the middle, he pulls it out, goes up for a big gain. And then this time it's Owen Schmidt again. The defensive end collapses down. Great read by Pat White, and he goes around the right end. So same play, once to the left, once to the right. And they ran that football all the way down the field.
On third and seven, Pittsburgh brings pressure up the middle and drops White. A little stunt there. Joe Clairmont, the defensive end, looped around and got the quarterback.
Exactly right. And Dave Wannstedt told Aaron Andrews walking off the field at the end of the first half that we're bringing pressure. We're just not getting to him. That time they brought the pressure. They actually were able to get to him, but Pat White and Steve Slayton, despite the Mounties punting here, pretty good night for both of those players.
Yeah, Kinder, the guy through the block, he's back there again, but Revis is the deep man. No rugby punt, they just kick it straight away. And this time it's Kinder. And Revis throw a block for him. A little return out to the...
Sprinkling in a few runs.
Power formation here, two tight ends as Kinder comes in motion. Palko looks that way quickly, loops the ball out, almost intercepted by Lewis. Lewis had a chance. The man who just made the sack had the pick in his hands. Not a good decision by Palko that time, huh?
That's the second time we've seen him throw to the left flat and have some miscommunication where a West Virginia defensive back has almost stepped in front of it and gone about 45 or 50 yards right down the sideline for a touchdown. What I'm seeing is West Virginia is bringing a lot of pressure and a lot of blitzing when they see LaRod Stevens-Howling, the 175-pound tailback. They're trying to run right through him with linebackers.
Final 30 seconds of the third quarter. Now, that would have been it. I mean, Lewis makes that catch, takes it the other way. That's it. Rain starting to fall a bit more now. Pittsburgh in that fourth quarter, Kirk, is going to have to turn around and go into that wind right toward the river. That's a tougher end for the kickers and for the quarterback. Palko has Kinder open, but slides it downfield. And a first down at the 45-yard line to Marcel Pastano.
West Virginia is a defense that is known to play a lot of zone defense. And one thing that Tyler Palko, who is relentless with his preparations, told me yesterday was they have to be able to find pockets. And that time they were able to give him time, so he was able to find that hole to put it in there.
This will be the final play of the third quarter. Palko trying to direct traffic, but he'll be hammered at the 41. Johnny Dingle there for the sack, combining with the safety John Holmes. So Pittsburgh down by 11 in a victory.